I told my family, they thought I was ridiculous. I told my friends, they were certain I was mad. But there was one friend who is a triathlete, super fit, like this is totally his thing. And I called him up and I told him what I was planning to do. And he said, look, Jeffrey, I don't want to be unsupportive. But when you go to the horse races, there's a reason why you don't see any Clydesdales. The best way to get me to do something is to tell me I can't do it. My mom used it all the time. She'd be like, I bet you can't do that laundry. I'd be like, I bet I can. Bet you can't rub lotion on my feet. Oh, yes, I can. You just watch me. So I started training for this. Of course, it was easier in the beginning, and then it got worse. My typical week looked like this. On a Tuesday, I would do a medium length run, somewhere between 8 and 18 miles, with some speed work in the middle. Wednesday, a really low-key recovery day, just 5 miles. On Thursday, another medium length run with speed work in the middle. No running on Friday. Saturday, long run, usually marathon distance. Sunday, another long run, usually another marathon. At the end, I was averaging just above 70 miles per week. I guess a lot of things can go wrong. A lot of things can go wrong when you're trying to run that far. For me, my toenails are a big issue. When your toenails hit against the end of your shoe 2,337 times, they slowly die, and then they fall off. I have a lot of problems eating enough. If you run out of enough energy, which you guys, up until this point, I had no idea what it felt like to truly be hungry. I had never once let myself get to the point of true hunger.